Hello everyone, and welcome to the CSS Security Mini Briefing, where we will present a short summary of what was released today, March 12th, 2023. My name is Josh Daniel, and I'm a risk manager in the customer service and support organization here at Microsoft. We're going to start this video with an overview of the release, and then we'll dive into a few vulnerabilities. Please note that the details of the vulnerabilities we are covering in this video may change, and the authoritative location for information will always be the online content in the security update guide. Now, before I dig into today's release, I like to compare it to the previous 12 months to see how it stacks up. We've been averaging around 72.5 vulnerabilities in each release over the past 13 months, and this month we have 60 newly disclosed CVEs in today's release. Next, I'll talk about scoring, where Microsoft uses the industry standard CVSS, or Common Vulnerability Scoring System. This is a scale between 1 and 10, where 10 represents the most risk. This month we have the highest rated CVE coming in at 9.8 on that scale of 10, and we've been averaging just over 9.5 over the past 13 months. Next, I'll look at the average CVSS score across the entire release. We've been averaging around 7.3 over the past year or so, and this month our average score is 7.58, so a little elevated compared to what we've been seeing. Next, I'll talk about remote code execution vulnerabilities. These are the vulnerabilities that typically provide the most risk. They would allow an attacker to install software onto a machine in certain circumstances. We've been averaging just over 25 of these remote code execution vulnerabilities in each release. This month, we have 18 remote code execution vulnerabilities in today's release. Next, I'll talk about publicly disclosed vulnerabilities, of which there are 0 this month, and we've been averaging just under 1. And finally, I'll talk about vulnerabilities known to be exploited. And this month, again, we have 0 in today's release, but we've been averaging right around 1.7 per month. All right, so now let's take a look at today's release. And those of you that have seen this video before, you'll recognize where we put the Windows products towards the bottom of the chart. And then as we move up, we get into products that aren't necessarily serviced every single month. And that's certainly the case this month, where Windows products down at the bottom, we've been averaging in the mid-30s for most Windows products. And that's kind of what we're seeing here, a little bit lower for some of the older operating systems, such as Server 2016 and Windows 10 1607. As we move up the chart, we have 3 vulnerabilities in Office this month. We've been averaging right around 6, so a little bit lower there. Microsoft Exchange Server has a vulnerability this month. We'll talk to that in just a few moments. Visual Studio and .NET 7 and 8, some of our developer tools have a handful of vulnerabilities being addressed this month. Dynamics 365 has a vulnerability that's being addressed, as well as SQL Server. Windows Defender, Skype for Consumer, Intune Company Portal, Microsoft Authenticator, Microsoft Outlook for Android all have updates this month. And finally, there are 2 updates in Open Management Infrastructure, or OMI, that also affect SCOM, and we'll talk to those in just a few minutes. Okay, let's dive into some of the vulnerabilities from today's release. And the first one that I will talk to is CVE-2024-21407. This is a critical remote code execution vulnerability in Hyper-V, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. This has a base score of 8.1 on that scale of 10. The attack vector is over the network, the attack complexity is high, privileges required is none, and user interaction is also none. Now, this vulnerability allows an attacker to execute arbitrary code on the host server. However, successful exploitation requires the attacker to be authenticated on a guest virtual machine. In other words, if an attacker gains access to a guest VM within the Hyper-V environment, they can use this vulnerability to execute malicious code onto the host operating system. There are no documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability, and all versions of Windows that are in support are affected here, whether it's Windows 10 or 11 on desktop, or Server 2016, 2019, or Server 2022. Next, I'll talk to CVE-2024-26198. This is an important remote code execution vulnerability in Exchange Server. This was privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. The CVSS base score is 8.8 on that scale of 10. The attack complexity is low, privileges required is none, user interaction is required. This vulnerability allows an attacker to execute arbitrary code onto a vulnerable Exchange server. The attack vector involves placing a specially crafted DLL file, or dynamic link library, into a network share or other file sharing resource, and then convincing a user to open it. So a little bit of hurdle there in that user interaction is required. No documented mitigations or workarounds for this vulnerability. And one thing I'll note about servicing is that with Exchange Server, the security update is installed onto a supported version of Exchange. And as of March, there are three supported versions of Exchange. That's Exchange 2016 Cumulative Update 23, Exchange 19 Cumulative Update 13, and Exchange 2019 Cumulative Update 14. If you are on one of those three versions of Exchange, to protect yourself from this vulnerability is one step, is to install the security update that was released today. If you're on an older version of Exchange, you would first need to upgrade your Exchange infrastructure to a supported version and then install the security update. So again, if you're using a version of Exchange that's not listed here under affected software, your first step is to upgrade to a supported version of Exchange and then install the security update in order to protect yourself from this vulnerability. And the affected software is Exchange 2016 Cumulative Update 23, Exchange 2019 Cumulative Update 13, and Exchange 2019 Cumulative Update 14. And the last vulnerability that I will talk to today is CVE-2024-21334. This is a vulnerability in the Open Management Infrastructure. This is remote code execution. The severity is important, privately disclosed with no known exploits out in the wild. Open Management Infrastructure is an open source project. This is used by Microsoft and the SCOM agents, and is also used in many different other products, both within Microsoft and outside of Microsoft. As far as this specific vulnerability, the only Microsoft products that are affected are the open source OMI project, as well as SCOM 2019 and SCOM 2022, or System Center Operations Manager. The base score here is 9.8 on that scale of 10. So this is hitting that high watermark of the highest scored vulnerability in today's set. The attack vector is over the network. The attack complexity is low. Privileges required is none, and no user interaction is required to leverage this vulnerability. Another thing I'll point out is it's not the System Center Operations Manager instance that is vulnerable. It's only the management pack that's used for Linux and Unix. So it's that very specific management pack for Linux and Unix that is vulnerable here. So the fix here is just to install that management pack if you're already managing Linux and Unix servers. If you're not managing Linux and Unix servers, then you're not vulnerable. You're only vulnerable when that management pack is installed. So if you have that management pack installed, go ahead and update your management pack on your operations manager environment to protect yourself from this highly rated CVE. Okay, that's it for the vulnerabilities that I will talk to today. If you are a Microsoft Premier or Unified Support customer and you would like to attend the full briefing call where we cover more content and are available to answer questions, you can either work with your CSAM to sign you up, or you can sign yourself up in Services Hub under the newsletters and search for Security Briefing and select your region and language. I want to thank everyone for joining me today, and I will talk to you all next month. Thank you.